I really like the updates to Leon's design in the RE2 remake. It's similar to the original, but also more realistic, with darker colours and the pads replaced with a tactical vest. It looks more like actual SWAT gear rather than the weird caricature that's designed to make Leon stand out against the rest of the cops. Even the detail of him getting it at the station instead of wearing it there makes it feel so much more natural in this version. But they do something else with it that I think is a really nice, possibly unintentional touch. Oh yeah, spoilers from here on out. After Leon gets shot and Ada patches him up, instead of a big dumb bandage that goes over the outside of his outfit, Ada applies the bandages underneath his outfit and doesn't put the undershirt back on him. This leaves Leon with short sleeves for the rest of the game. The significance of this is that the short sleeves, coupled with the darker blue, makes Leon resemble his RE4 counterpart quite a bit. This could be seen as a representation of Leon transforming from his naive RE2 self into his wiser, not so easily trusting self from later in the timeline by the end of the game. He certainly feels like he's grown by the time he confronts Ada about her true motives. Again, it may not be intentional, but I still think it's a cool little bit of symbolism regardless. I also like how his street clothes at the start of the game have white trainers. I have to wonder if it's a nod to how his in-game model in the original looks like he was wearing trainers instead of boots. As for Claire, while I think the outfit is more generic than either of the two previous takes on RE2 Claire, I did find something I kinda liked with the new one too. For most of my first playthrough as Claire, there was something the outfit reminded me of, but I couldn't place it. Was it RE6 Ada? The red top was right, but not the black pants or the high-heeled boots. BSAA Jill? The pants were definitely blue, but the top wasn't. No, as it turned out, it was Claire's second outfit from Revelations 2, where she has a red shirt and blue pants. Red top and blue pants is now firmly Claire's clothing style of choice, so it's nice for the outfits, while lacking in personality, to at least feel consistent with the modern version of the character. But am I the only one who finds Claire's loose ponytail and her tank top and pants combo weirdly reminiscent of modern Lara Croft? Am I crazy? Oh, wait, 4 new shows in 1 year. Yeah, I'm crazy. Carry on. The classic costume, on the other hand, looks off and you may not be able to place why. It's the lack of sleeves and gloves. Not because those components are vital for the outfit, but because they provide some vital colour balance with the added black that is not present in the new version. I think I get why they did it this way. The new outfit has a tank top and no gloves too, so it prevents certain problems with the model, like clipping issues, and makes it easier to create, but it ends up like Superman without the briefs. Too much blue and not enough red, or in this case, too much pink and not enough black. I'm not big on Ada's new look though. After all, if you're a spy and you look the part, you're doing it wrong. Her use of the cocktail dress underneath is appreciated, simply for not decking her out with gloves and belts in a way that suggests she specifically dressed this way to deal with the zombies, like with the previous iterations of this costume, or with the modern version of Jill's RE3 costume. Sherry looks adorable now, and actually doesn't look like she attends a Japanese middle school this time. Mr. X's new hat makes him look like a woke vegan hipster sees themselves, which makes you hate him about as much as the pursuit mechanics do. And his new final form reminds me a lot of Ustinak from RE6, and feels like it was an attempt at finally fulfilling the potential of a fight with the RE1 tyrant. And a few more quick thoughts on the aesthetic. The sewer now looks like a sewer instead of a Zelda dungeon. The RPD reception desk being in front of the goddess statue instead of behind makes a lot more sense, as do the staircases at either side replacing the ladder. And the liquors strike the right balance between the weedy buggers of old and the Roid Rage RE5 version, with that sickly yellow muscle for added effect. Overall, I have to say the visuals of this game are fucking astounding, not just for fidelity, but from an aesthetic standpoint as well. But Mr. X can still get fucked.